Right then, folks. Can you hear me? Can you hear me? If you can, we'll begin to make a start. We'll load in. Once I can see the chat moving and you say you can hear me, I will move straight across. I think you can. I'm not entirely sure. We will see. Can you hear me? That is the question. I am awaiting the answers. Michael's not here today, neither is Kieran, so... Hey dear, here we go. Lewis has told me he can hear me. Happy days, happy days. So, we'll move in. Number quiz. How are we all doing? I hope we're all having a good week. I hope everything's been okay. I know life's starting to slowly go back to normal. So, I hope we're all kind of getting on as best we can, that kind of thing. Have we all had a good week? Have we all had a good week? Everyone's now talking about music taste and that kind of shit. Cool, everyone's talking. Nice, nice, nice. You can all hear me. So, this week I've switched it up a bit. I've not gone for the standard stuff that we've been going for. I've mixed it up a couple of rounds. No more flags this week. I'm very sorry. But yeah, we've gone for questions 1 to 5, celebrities. Questions 6 to 10, British cinema. 11 to 15, science and nature. 16 to 20, sports champions specifically. 21 to 25 is going to be finish the lyric. 26 to 30 is going to be TV show sets. 31 to 35 is going to be companies or brands. And 36 to 40, as always, is just general knowledge. So, we'll jump straight into it, I guess. So question number one, I'll correct my timer. Here we are. Question number one, as always, which celebrity is this from their younger years? Which celebrity is this from their younger years? I know, rip fun with flags. Look, flags is a bit of a pain. I either put in some random, like, Middle Eastern country and then John tells me that, like, he's not happy and I've made it up. Or I put in very obvious ones and everyone gets 5 points. I can never win, so fuck the flags. We've done something else. Maybe. We'll see what happens. We'll see what happens. We might bring flags back. Week 10. We might bring week 10. Should we do an all flags? No, I'm kidding. I wouldn't dare do that. John might kill me. but yeah, we're going to give you around a minute per question. For anyone that is new around here, around a minute per question. And then we move on to the next one and we keep on going. So you've got a couple more seconds on this one. But tell me, who is this from their younger years? 3, 2, 1. Question number 2. What is the name of the eldest child of David and Victoria Beckham? What is the name of the eldest child of David and Victoria Beckham? I think this one's easy. Of course, I think it, I tell you every week it's easy, and then everyone's like, that was really hard. So, I can never win. I can never win. This is where we're at. How are we all doing? Have we had a good week? Have we done anything different? Have we done anything new? How is the world where you are right now? What's work been like? How are we all? Someone let me know. With no flags, I'll be amazed if I get double figures. You never know, Carl, you never know. Last few seconds on this one. What is the name of the eldest child of David and Victoria Beckham? Give you a couple more seconds. So as always, we like to throw in a random dress. The Grammy Awards have always brought out the creative side to people when it comes to outfits, but who wore this to the 2010 Grammys? Who wore this dress in 2010? Who wore this dress to the Grammys? And is that... I don't understand what that is on their hand. Are they carrying that? Is that on their wrist? Is it a scepter? I don't understand. They celebrated Coventry City being the League One champions. Nice. New COD update's terrible. I don't agree. I think it's okay. Remember that time when you got 0 kills and I got 9 and hit that guy midair? Yep, do. Thing is though, Mickey, in here, the COD chat doesn't matter to anyone else, so fair play, bro. Went back to the office for the first time in 3 months. It was amazing. Back working from home now. Do you know what? It is nice to go back to places when you've not been for a while. I feel you on that, Leslie. Working from home's a bit dead, a bit boring. Don't like it. So we'll move into question number 4. Billy Lord is one of the stars of American Horror Story. She wasn't the first in her family to be an actress, though. Who is Lord's mother? Billy Lord is one of the stars of American Horror Story. She wasn't the first in her family to be a famous actress, though. Who is Lord's mother? says very famous celebrity actress mother. Tell me who. Gareth, no, it don't matter to you. You suck, bro. You suck. Who's Billy Lord's mum? Tell me who's Billy Lord's mum. PS5 or Xbox Series X? I'm poor as fuck, so neither. Neither of them. If you're going to make me pick, probably Xbox, because that'll be what my friends will pick, and then we can all game together. Yeah, probably Xbox. I don't know. I don't care for next gen at the moment. I don't game. I've only gamed a lot during lockdown, because it's lockdown. But, you know. Question number 5. How many times was Leonardo DiCaprio nominated for an Academy Award before finally winning one? How many times was Leonardo DiCaprio nominated for an Academy Award before finally winning one? That's what it's all day. My second at work was extended, and work are talking about getting thought more of a working from home, work from the office balance. A balance would be good, obviously keeps you safe for the most part, and obviously when you go to the office they keep you safe there, and especially if you do it in like split rotor, so fingers crossed Leon that goes well. Wi-Fi router or mini fridge. Mini fridge holds my beer. I like it. So question round number 2 this week is on British cinema. So British films, British actors, that kind of thing. Let's have a go. Question number 6. Andrew Shim plays Milky in which British film? Andrew Shim plays Milky in which British film? I didn't know one for Titanic baffles me. Hey, well, you know what? I think the film that he did finally win it for was very deserving of one. Of course, lots of things he's done before have been deserving, but the film he did win it for was very deserving. Andrew Shim plays Milky in which British film? This British film's great. Staple of British cinema at this point. What film does he play Milky? I've got question number 7. Kez is a British drama film directed by Ken Loach. In what year was it released? And I'll give you a year each way. So if you get the year before or the year after, you can also have the point. What year was Kez released? Brilliant film is Kez. I love it. Has anyone not seen Kez? Has anyone not seen it? I feel like it's really iconic and everyone will have seen it, but you just never know. What's Kez? Bro! Scott, no, Scott. Question number 8. What is the name of the character that Ewan McGregor plays in Trainspotting? What is the name of the character that Ewan McGregor plays in Trainspotting? I like all northerners are like jumping in. Those northerners, we love a bit of kids. What? Sean's not heard of it. Wow. What point? How far south do we go until Kez stops? Where Rotherham and Sheffield? Sean's Nottingham. When does it stop? I know you'll have never seen it, Josh. You don't watch fucking good films, bro. No! Oh, Chloe, don't type it in the chat. You're gonna give everyone the answer. Oh, I can't delete it either. Oh, can I? Can I delete it? Yeah, I can. I'm so sorry, Chloe, I had to delete that. Next question. The Full Monty follows a group of guys who have become a male striptease act. but what were their jobs before? Full Monty follows a group of guys who have become a male striptease act. What were their jobs before? This one's also a northern thing. I feel like British cinema, I've just turned into northern cinema. Not seen Trainspotting. Right, I'm throwing it out there. I'm not bothered if you've not seen Kez. Kez is great, but Kez isn't that much of a staple. If you've not seen Trainspotting, folks, watch Trainspotting. Please watch Trainspotting. So Happy Gilmore's not a good film. It's one good film, fam. This is definitely a northerner's film. Definitely a northerner's film. And then question number 10. Jason Statham and Vinnie Jones feature alongside each other in which 1998 Guy Ritchie film? Jason Statham and Vinnie Jones feature alongside each other in which 1998 Guy Ritchie film? Northern cinema is British cinema. Damn right, brother. Damn right. I watch a football one. That's Northern. Is it Jimmy Kimmel? Northern cinema or get the fuck out. Damn right. I'm on the Northerners. That's what we're about. And then round number 3 is going to be science and nature. Question number 11. What is the biggest planet in our solar system? What is the biggest planet in our solar system? Have we all seen the planets before? I tell you what I'm going to do, folks, right? All these quizzes I've always gone, oh, this film you need to watch it, this film you need to watch it. I'm going to write a list and I'm going to publish it on Twitter, whatever. And they're going to be lists of films that you need to watch. Like, my tutor once did it for me whilst I was doing my degree. He gave me a list of like 40 films that you have to watch. I'm going to do that for you lot, right? That's what I'm going to do. What's the biggest planet in our solar system? What's a planet, bro? Question number 12. If you were to study hippology, what animal would you be studying? If you were to study hippology, what animal would you be studying? Thank feck Braveheart wasn't a question. Hey, my anus is the biggest planet in the solar system, bro. Thank feck Braveheart, man. I should have put Braveheart in there. How sad would it be, though, if you got the Braveheart question wrong, if there was one there? Mighty Ducks will be on that list for me. Fam! Mighty Ducks is a good film because we're hockey fans, but if you're talking just general film, pretty standard. In my opinion, of course, in my opinion. Moving to question number 13. What is the chemical symbol for silver? What is the chemical symbol for silver? Are you called Hugh Jass? You're so funny, Josh. You're so funny, mate. Ah, dear. For those of you that are wondering what I'm drinking this week, that it's not in a tin, I ran out of beer. So I'm on the spirits this evening. A little bit of Captain Jack. Oh dear. Captain Morgan Spice Rum. Slapshot's better than Mighty Ducks. That could cause a war. That could cause a war. Never seen Braveheart and will never watch it. Leanne! Wow! I don't blame you. I don't blame you. Question number 14. If you're scared of thunder and lightning, you have which phobia? If you're scared of thunder and lightning, you have which phobia? There's a specific name for what kind of phobia this is. That's what I'm looking for. Captain Jack Sparrow. You know it, brother. S- Slapshot better than Mighty Ducks. God. That's a shout, though. I think I'd agree to some extent. But that would cause a war in the hockey community, right? That's like Red Cake or BAP or whatever the fuck you call what I call a Red Cake. That's that kind of war. Thunder Buddies for life. Fuck you, Thunder. Fuck you, Thunder. Best hockey film of all time is MVP, Most Valuable Primate. underrated film. MVP is a banger. Question number 15. What is the collective name for a group of lions? What is the collective name for a group of lions? Bomb. Get the fuck out, Gareth. Get out with yourself. Bomb. Be a fucking bomb. I'm not starting it. No. Right, chat. But before it even starts, chat, please don't. Please don't. Let's not start this bread cake argument. We all call it different things. We can all be civil about it. Please don't start. It's a roll. No, stop, stop. Give you a couple more seconds on this one and we'll move into question 16, which was the start of sports champions. Bread cake, Cobb. No, stop. Lewis, Cobb, fam. Ah, oh, you're from like Worktop way though, aren't you? Fuck you. Muffin? No. Stop it. All right. Next question. The 1992-93 season was the first season of what is now known as the Premier League. Who won the inaugural season? The 1992-93 season was the first season of the Premier League. Who won the inaugural season? And no, we can't be civil. Yes, we can be civil. Right? We're all here to have a relaxing Friday. In Manchester, it's even a bar more in some places. A muffin. No. If batch all the answers go together and batch. No. What have we done? Why? We got to week 9 and we've got a civil war inside the chat. Oh, man. Who won the first ever season of what's now known as the Premier League? So I'm not asking for Division 1, I'm not asking for the top tier of British football. I'm saying specifically the Premier League in 1992-93. Question number 17. How many times has tennis star Roger Federer won a Wimbledon singles title? How many times has tennis star Roger Federer won a Wimbledon singles title? It's like calling a dressing gown a house coat. You don't call your slippers your house shoes. Rah! Stop! We're not having it! Why are you like this chat? You've been lovely for 8 weeks. Why at week 9 are we now imploding? Wait, actually, I say you've been lovely. Carry on. Argue amongst yourselves. It takes it away from me being abused this week. Question number 18. The St. Louis Blues are currently the NHL Stanley Cup champions, but who did they beat in the finals? The St. Louis Blues are the current NHL Stanley Cup champions. Who did they beat in the finals? I mean, you started this house coat. I thought that's what you put on when your dad won't turn thermostat up. Wouldn't know the feeling, bro. St. Louis Blues are the current NHL Stanley Cup champions. Who did they beat in the finals? Does chocolate belong in your fridge or cupboard? Josh, you know what? Shut up, man. Stop starting these arguments. Some belongs in fridge and some belongs in cupboard. Rah. Question number 19. Who are the current champions of the NBA? Who are the current champions of the NBA? Still my head. What about ketchup? No, stop! Mickey! Stop it! I'm losing control of the chat. Is this how you feel, Mickey, when I come up in your chat just starting shit? Who are the current champions of the NBA? Possibly my favourite question on the entire quiz is this one. Who would you have for this year's cup? The Leafs, all the way. My boys. Question number 20. Who holds the record for the most Ballon d'Or trophy wins? I don't even know how to say this. Is it Ballon d'Or? Ballon d'Or? Anyway, who holds the record for the most Ballon d'Or trophy wins? We're waiting for a spelling mistake. You are waiting for a spelling mistake, Liam. But currently, I'm 2 weeks in a row without one. So let's make this three, right? We've got this. I've learned how to spell. Here we go. Balloon d'Or. Yeah, I'll go for Balloon d'Or. Who holds the most Balloon d'Or trophy wins? I thought it was Dior, technically. But I've only ever heard it pronounced d'Or rather than Dior. So... I don't know, man. We're moving to round number 5, which is going to be finish the lyric. So this round's going to be worth 10 points. So there's a grand total of 45 points up for grabs this week, because if you can tell me the song name and person who sings it as well as the... the person who sings it. So, question 21. I hurt myself today to see if I still feel. I focus on the pain. Blank, 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 blank. Country and Blues. There was a spelling mistake on the first slide with quarantine instead of quarantine. Oh no, no. Bollocks! Don't say that, because I've been posting that picture everywhere. Is that true? No, don't. No, wait, hang on. Quarantine. No! Quarantine. I've got it right? I hurt myself today to see if I still feel. I focus on the pain. Blank, 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 blank. It's Nine Inch Nails covered by a country singer. All right, well, whatever, fam. Like, I've got specifically the country one, so write that down, okay? Question 22. You know you love me, I know you care. Just blank, 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 blank. You know you love me, I know you care, just blank, 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 blank. Get the bonus point for telling me the song name and the person who sings it too. Banger of a song. Oh wait, you've not skipped. I've just realised that you're still on the other one. I was like, Gareth? You know you love me, I know you care, just blank, 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 blank. Moving into question 23. If you're 555, then I'm 666, blank, 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 blank. How many times can Ryan say the word blank? Until it doesn't sound like a real word anymore. Yeah, Gareth, really, bro. That second song's a banger. If you're 555, then I'm 666. Blank, 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 blank. Of course, this is metal music. Moving to question number 24. Rolling down the street smoking Indo, blank, 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 laid back, rap. Rolling down the street smoking Indo, blank, 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 laid back, rap music. It's really hard not to sing these songs, by the way, guys. Really fucking hard. Especially this one. My kind of vibe. What's it like to lose a lead in Game 7 of the playoffs? That's the ending to the 5-5-5 one. See? Also covered by NoFX. Alright, alright, Mickey, we get it. You're no music fan. Get it. Rolling down the street smoking indoor, blank, 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 blank. Laid back. Can we get rid of this round? It won't stay, Scott. I'll be honest, I threw it in there because I was running out of time this week. I had lots of stuff to do, so I picked an easy round for me to make. And number 25. I've got a secret. It's on the tip of my tongue. Blank, 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 blank. And I'm going to keep it. You've missed question 21. Wow. We'll go back to that. I've got a secret. It's on the tip of my tongue. Blank, 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 blank. I'm going to keep it. Easy claps. To be fair, Mickey, all five of these songs are fucking simple. This will be my favourite round. Right, just quickly, for Leanne, we're going to go back. Question 21. I hurt myself today to see if I still feel. I focus on the pain. Blank, 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 blank. I hurt myself today to see if I still feel. I focus on the pain. Blank, 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 blank. 25. So, yeah, right. It's technically rock, I guess. It could be all sorts of stuff, to be honest. But it is screamo. It is rock. It's emo. It's hardcore. It's whatever, but we went with rock, alright? Just shut up, man. Number 26, this is obviously the TV sets. So, which TV show is this set from? Which TV show is this specific set from? I see, we've turned on me. We've turned on me. You all went for each other. Now we've turned on me because I call that other thing rock. Hey, sing to you. I'll sing to you when I give you the answer, bro. I'll sing to you when I give you the answer. They aren't as good as they used to be. That is a fact, Sean. That is a fact. But they're doing their own thing now, so I can't fault it. Tell me, what TV show is this set from? Legendary show. Very legendary show. Anyway, 27. What TV show is this set from? This one's easy. Even if you'd never watched this, you'd know this. Used to love wondering about Chef, hoping to bump into him. I bumped into him a few times, Sean. I bumped into him a few times. Yeah. Number 28. Which TV show is this from? Which TV show is this set from? Glee's Bedroom. Hey, to be fair, man. With my little like fairy lights and that behind me, I could do this. I could paint the like the letters on my my wall. He's in Russia. Is he? Oh wait. Seeing Sean is so jealous right now. Should have stayed in Nottingham and got peed on, apparently, Sean. You would have had a song named after you. Jesus Christ. This chat, fam. Number 29. Which TV show set is this? What TV show is this from? Glee has a slug called Dart. Fuck's sake, man. mate at the time, I'd have let him. Wow! What is this chat? Wow! Sean's like, yeah, I'll let a guy pee on me. Fucking hell. Hopper in his emotional prison. So what TV show is this from? Brilliant TV show is this one. And then number 30. Which TV show is this from? Mother Walkden got this. Mom, the Mother Walkden. Yes! I assume you meant 29, not 30, of course. There's a bit of a delay, but either way, Mom the Mother. What TV set is this from? And then round 7, we've got a new one this week. John said casting couch. Jesus Christ. This chat is descending into madness. Right, round 7 this week is brands or companies. We'll move into that one in a second. We'll give you a couple more minutes on this, a couple more seconds on this one. She definitely got this. Fair play. Question number 31. Which brand's logo is this? Of course, I've taken the text out. But which brand's logo is this? Daft, this is a difficult one, Ryan. Struggling with it. Hey, look. Right, Leanne. I've got to throw easy ones in there, otherwise Gareth won't get some any points, you know? Which brand's logo is this? He has a brown leather settee across from his desk, I heard. Fam, on the other side of me is a wall, bro. Fucking hell. What's going on? Oh, man. 15 more seconds on this one. Fucking hell, boys. What are you broing at, Gareth? Fuck you, bro. Question number 32. This logo is clearly of that of LG, but what does LG stand for? This logo is clearly that of LG, but what does LG stand for? Poor Dots. Damn right, poor Dots. He's been taking it all week as well, to be fair. His cross-check order had a hashtag white rose in it. The logo is clearly that of LG, but what does LG stand for? Little Glee. Oh, man. Name of his pee-pee. Fam, why are you going to do this to me, bro? That's killed me off, that fam. Fuck my life. Question number 33. Which musical instrument can be usually found alongside a Guinness? Which musical instrument can usually be found alongside a Guinness? So Guinness has a logo. What musical instrument is on that logo? Honestly, man. What is this week? What's going on this week, man? What is it? What's going on? Which musical instrument can be usually found alongside a Guinness? Surprised he hasn't called it Woody Woompecker. Fuck my life, Josh! Jesus Christ, fam. For the record, chat, by the way, Josh is 16, he shouldn't know jokes like that. He shouldn't know. He's a good boy, apparently. Fuck you, Josh, man. Question number 34. In 1992, Tony Hawk started his own skateboarding company. What is that company called? In 1992, Tony Hawk started his own skateboarding company. What is that company called? LG must be losing grasp, Brian, of tonight's chat. Hey, Carl, you're not wrong. Chat's on its own fucking world right now. Normally, I'm like, I'll ask a question, you guys will answer, we'll be all nice. I might get laughed at for, like, spelling something wrong. This week, it's all just fucking gone wild, hasn't it? All gone fucking nuts. Thank God next week's week 10 and I'm thinking about ending it, because, gee, you lot are out of fucking hand this week. It's been a while since I've been a teacher, you know. It's been nearly a full year. Like, I ain't got the ability to fucking control you lot right now. And then question 35, the last one of brands and companies. Which record label does this logo belong to? Tony Hawk Pro Skater 2, what a soundtrack. I preferred Pro Skater 1, which is getting remastered. Yes. Pro Skater 2 was a banger, though. Which record label does this belong to? We've all got too comfortable with each other. That's exactly where it is, Sean. The first couple of weeks, you're all like, oh, I don't know where people's like humour is. I don't know where people's temperaments are. You didn't know each other. Now you've all been here for the past 9 weeks. You're all like, ah, fucking dick jokes and stuff. Horrendous. A lot of you. Horrendous. This week, man. I don't think I've laughed this much during a quiz, to be fair, so fair play to you all. Tony Hawk's Underground. Underground was good. American Wasteland, that. You have, to be fair, Mickey, you have cussed me since week one. That's because I come into your chat every day and cuss you. At least mine's only once a week, fam. Question 36, general knowledge back again. Which city will be the host of the 2024 Olympic Games? Of course, 2020 was delayed due to COVID-19. But which city will be the host of the 2024 Olympic Games? I don't know how you do it, Mickey. I get cussed out once a week. How do you get cussed out, like, multiple times a week? I can't live with this. I can't live with this every day. I don't know how streamers do it, man. Which city will be the host of the 2024 Olympic Games? Your life would be boring without us. You're not wrong, Liam. You're not wrong. I can't even deny that. Which city will be the host of the 2024 Olympic Games? Give you 5 seconds or so on this one. 37. Ben Nevis and Snowdon are two parts of the Three Peak Challenge. Which other UK mountain completes it? Ben Nevis and Snowdon are two parts of the Three Peak Challenge. Which other UK mountain completes it? Need drink. What, laughing and chatting and madness is easy. I was more cracked. Most of us cuss you out without the quiz anyways. You're not fucking wrong, Gareth. Every fucking day, you, man. Every day. You're the worst, fam. Ben Nevis and Snowdon are two parts of the Three Peak Challenge. Which other UK mountain completes it? This one's got to be an easy one, right? Maybe? I don't know. We'll move on. Question number 38. According to their own website, what is the most popular flavour of Walker's crisps? According to their own website, what is the most popular flavour of Walker's crisps? This one's just potluck. No research could have possibly gone into this for any of you that like to do whatever and read up on pointless shit. No way anyone could know this. Surely it's just going to be a guess for everyone, right? But according to their own website, they do have a most popular flavour. Which is it? My dad's done this. Hey, big up your dad, because I don't think I could do any of those mountains. I love walking. I've done multiple like hills and stuff. But I don't think I could do the Three Peak Challenge. My body ain't cut for that, bro. I'd love to, though. I'd love to get fit and do it. It'd be ace. I need to go out and walk, man. Me and you, Lou. Let's do it, man. Let's go out and do a big fucking hike somewhere, man. We need to bring back barbecue flavour. I fully, fully agree with this. Barbecue walkers need to come back. Question number 39. In what year was the first generation of iPhone released? And I've been nice enough to give you some multiple choice. 2005, 2006, 2007, or 2008. In what year was the first generation of iPhone released? 05, 06, 07, or 08? Glee can do three pizza challenge. I bet I couldn't, you know, man. I'm a right little bitch when it comes to food. As much as I talk a big game, I can't, like, me and Pete tried to have 20 wings from KFC, that whole 20 bucket wing bucket thing that they did. And I was like 15 in, and I was like, oh, I don't think I can finish, bro. Honestly, man, I just talk a big game, innit? What year was the first iPhone released? Munro Baggin. Frodo Baggin. What's going on? What's Munro Baggin? Anyway, the last one, as we all know, as we've all become accustomed to, this is week 9. The final question, I always ask you, who is older? So this week, 2020 sees Joe Biden go up again. Oh shit, voice break. Go up against. 2020 sees Joe Biden go up against Donald Trump in the election race. Who is older out of the two? Who's older, Joe Biden or Donald Trump? Who is older, Joe Biden or Donald Trump? I finally hit puberty. Hey, not yet. Not yet, Chloe, not yet. So, guys, it's currently 20 past. Balls have dropped. All right, lads, fuck me. It's currently 20 past. I'll give us 5 minutes or so to come back. So go and get yourself a toilet break. Go and get yourself a drink, more snacks, whatever. Give yourself 5 minutes and we will come back to get the answers. Catch you in 5. Can y'all hear me? If you can, we'll jump straight back in and we'll get the answers done. Once you can hear me, we will jump straight back in and get the answers done. Cool, you can hear me. Nice. So, we'll jump in. Hold on. There we are. We'll jump in with the questions then. In which case, howdy, 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 folks. Hope you're all doing well. We will jump in with the answers. Let's do it. Question one. This is Selena Gomez. The answer to question one is Selena Gomez. Question two. I asked you, what is the name of the eldest child of David and Victoria Beckham? Their name is Brooklyn. Brooklyn is the answer. Question number three. The Grammy Awards have always brought out the creative side to people when it comes to outfits. Who wore this dress in 2010? This is Lady Gaga. Lady Gaga is the answer for this one. Number four. Billie Lord is one of the stars of American Horror Story. She wasn't the first in her family to be a famous actress, though. Who is Lord's mother? Her mother's Carrie Fisher. Carrie Fisher is Billie Lord's mother. Question number five. How many times was Leonardo DiCaprio nominated for an Academy Award before finally winning one? The answer is six. He was nominated six times for an Academy Award. He was nominated Best Supporting Actor in What's Eating Gilbert Grape. He was also nominated for Best Actor in The Aviator, Best Actor in Blood Diamond, Best Actor in Wolf of Wall Street, Best Picture in Wolf of Wall Street, Best Actor in Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, and then he finally won one for The Revenant. So the answer to question five is six. Question six. Andrew Shim plays Milky in which British film? The answer is This Is England. The answer to question number six is This Is England. Question number seven. Kez is a British drama film directed by Ken Loach. In what year was it released? The answer is 1970. So you can have a point for 1969 or 1971, but the answer is 1970. Question number eight, I asked you, what is the name of the character that Ewan McGregor plays in Trainspotting? His name is Mark Rentboy Renton. So you can have Rentboy, you can have Mark Renton, you can have Renton. Mark Rentboy Renton. Question number nine, the Full Monty follows a group of guys who have become a male striptease act. What were their jobs before? They were steel workers. They were steel workers. Question number 10, I asked, Jason Statham and Vinnie Jones feature alongside each other in which 1998 film, Guy Ritchie film? The answer is Lock, Stock and Two Smoking Barrels. Lock, Stock and Two Smoking Barrels. Question 11. What is the biggest planet in our solar system? Nice and easy, the answer is Jupiter. Jupiter is the biggest planet in our solar system. Question number 12. If you were to study Hippology, What animal would you be? This is this week's red herring question. I'm hoping tons of people put hippopotamus. The answer is horses. The answer for question number 12 is horses. Question number 13. What is the chemical symbol for silver? It's Ag. Ag is the answer. Question number 14. If you're scared of thunder and lightning, you have which phobia? The answer is astrophobia. Astrophobia. Question number 15. What is the collective name for a group of lions? It's a pride. A pride of lions. Nice and easy on that one, I believe. Number 16, the 1992-93 season was the first season of the Premier League. Who won the inaugural season? But unfortunately, the answer is Manchester United. Unfortunately, fuck you, Gareth. Question number 17. How many times has tennis star Roger Federer won a Wimbledon's single title? He's won it 8 times. He won it in 03, 04, 05, 06, 07, 09, 12, and 17. He has won it 8 times. What a fucking guy. Question number 18. The St. Louis Blues are currently NHL Stanley Cup champions. Who did they beat in the finals? They beat the Boston Bruins. How much did you hate doing that question? I fucking hated doing that question, Gareth. Fuck Man United. These guys beat the Boston Bruins. Question number 19. Who are the current champions of the NBA? Of course, this is my favourite question. It is the boys, Toronto Raptors. Question number 20. Who holds the record for the most Ballon d'Or trophy wins? Lionel Messi. Of course it is. Of course it's Lionel Messi. It's Lionel Messi. Number 21, here we are. So, 21. I hurt myself today to see if I still feel. I focus on the pain, the only thing that's real. Johnny Cash hurt. The only thing that's real, Johnny Cash hurt. You know you love me, I know you care. Just shout whenever and I'll be there. Justin Bieber, baby. You know you love me, I know you care. Just shout whenever and I'll be there. Justin Bieber, baby. Number 23. If you're 555, then I'm 666. What's it like to be a heretic? What's it like to be a heretic? Slipknot, the heretic anthem. Nine Inch Nails hurt. Alright, Mickey. Whatever, man. I get it. Question number 24. Rolling down the street, smoking Indo, sipping on gin and juice, laid back. Snoop Dogg, gin and juice. The answer is sipping on gin and juice. Snoop Dogg, gin and juice. I ain't singing it, no way. Disgusting. Is it 2 points for this? Ice and song. So you get the point for getting the lyrics, Gareth. You also get the point for the person who sung it and the song title, so it's worth 2 points. You've got to get the lyrics for at least a point. I ain't singing them! No. I'm not having it. No. Number 25. I've got a secret. It's on the tip of my tongue. It's on the back of my lungs. And I'm going to keep it. Bring me the horizon, Chelsea Smile. The answer is, it's on the back of my lungs. Bring me the horizon, Chelsea Smile. 26. This is How I Met Your Mother. Of course it's How I Met Your Mother. And if anyone didn't see, Lewis put in the chat, legendary, because that's a joke from this TV show. So fair play to Lou. I'm balling for 10 points on this round. Everyone should be, really. Please listen to NoFX cover of Gin and Juice. It's awesome. I'll tell you what, Mickey, I'll do that right after this. The answer to question 26 is How I Met Your Mother. 27, of course, is Stranger Things. 27, Stranger Things. 28. How many people put The Office? Because that's not true. The answer is Parks and Recreation. Parks and Rec. Parks and Recreation. 29. Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. Fresh Prince of Bel-Air for 29. And number 30 is Coronation Street. Of course it's Coronation Street. If anyone got that wrong, I'm deeply disappointed. Coronation Street, question 30. Glee's Ted. I am fucking Ted, bro. And I ain't finding Mean Ho Robin anytime soon. 31. Which brand's logo is this? It's the North Face. The North Face. 32. The logo is clearly that of LG, but what does LG stand for? The answer is life's good. Life's good. 33. Which musical instrument can usually be found alongside a Guinness? The answer is a harp. Not a clarinet, Leslie. A harp. Number 34. In 1992, Tony Hawk started his own skateboarding company. What's that company called? That company is called Birdhouse. Birdhouse. Little Glee. I'm not having it, fam. Number 35. Which record label does this logo belong to? The answer is Island Records. Island Records. Number 36. Which city will be the host of the 2024 Olympic Games? The Olympic Games in 2024 will be hosted by Paris. Tokyo currently have a delay on the, obviously because of COVID, for 2020, but 2024 is going to be hosted in Paris. Number 37. Ben Nevis and Snowdon are two parts of the three-peak challenge. Which other UK mountain completes it? The answer is Scaffold Pike. Scaffold Pike, which is the smallest of the three. I put the two big ones in there. Scaffold Pike, the smallest of the three, is the answer for question number 37. You get a Birdhouse deck with a special edition of new remake. Yeah, I know, man, and I'm gassed. I'm excited, and I might order that. 38. According to their own website, what is the most popular flavour of Walker's crisps? Cheese and onion is the answer. Cheese and onion, which I think whoever's eating cheese and onion, you're a bit weird. Salt and vinegar are way better, but here we are. Cheese and onion is the answer to 38. 39. In what year was the first generation of the iPhone released? 05, 06, 07, 08. It was released in 2007. 2007. 13 years in to iPhones, and they've changed a hell of a lot. 2007 is the answer, C. And number 40, I asked you who's older, Joe Biden or Donald Trump? The answer is Joe Biden. Joe Biden is currently 77 years of age, and Donald Trump is 73 years of age. Biden is older than Trump. Cheese and onion and vile. I'm with you, Carl. I'm with you, man. I'm with you. So that's all 40. You've now got the answers for all 40. Let me know how you did on social media, Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, whatever you found me through. I thank you all for coming along, as always. I hope that you're all doing well, both physically and mentally. And as always, like I like to tell you, if there's anything going on in the world, if it's a bit too much for you, my DMs are always open for anyone. Make sure you're staying as healthy, mentally and physically, as possible. Thank you all for coming. Let me know how you've done. I love you all, and I will see you next week for week 10. Catch you later.